given the recent ever so subtle directional adjustments being gently eased in by the new US administration, you'd be forgiven for thinking that the American electric vehicle dream was now completely dead in the water, wouldn't you? But according to industry research company Cox Automotive, 2024 was actually a bumper year for EVs in the States, hitting a record 1.3 million new vehicle sales, representing an uplift of 7.3%, while the overall automotive market only grew by 2%. And that market share is projected to grow in 2025 too, pushing up well over 1.5 million sales. Here in the UK, the outlook is even rosier. About 20% of all new car sales in 2024 were battery electric, with absolutely no sign of a slowdown as we entered 2025. All those cars need batteries, of course, and all those batteries need critical minerals like lithium. And we've all heard the naysayers telling us how we're going to run out of all those materials and end up back in the dark ages by the middle of the century, haven't we? Utter nonsense, of course. But it makes for a good clickbait headline, I suppose. And arguably, that concern has also prompted researchers all over the world to rapidly accelerate experiments with alternative, more abundant and cheaper materials for battery chemistries. We've heard about sodium ion, for example, haven't we? Which is already in some Chinese vehicle batteries. But what about one of the most abundant and most widely recycled materials in the world? Aluminium, or aluminum if you're in North America. Why don't we just use that to replace the lithium? I'll tell you why, because it's absolutely useless, that's why. Until now. Hello, and welcome to Just Ever Think. Before we get stuck in, it's time for a shameless plug on behalf of my good friends over at the Fully Charged and Everything Electric channels. I'm delighted to say that they've invited me back to be a moderator for several of the discussion panels at the Everything Electric live show being held at XL London from Wednesday the 16th to Friday the 18th of April. All the usual attractions will be there, from home energy generation and storage solutions right through to the latest EV models and electric commercial vehicles. Plus there's loads of fun stuff to keep the kids occupied. Ticket prices have been slashed this year as well to make the event as accessible as possible to as many people as possible. And if you use the Just Have a Think discount code at the bottom of the screen now, you'll get an extra 20% off that already reduced price. Absolute bargain. So follow the link in the description to the Everything Electric ticket sales page, pop the dates in your diary, and I look forward to seeing you there. Right, where were we? I was completely slating aluminium as a battery chemistry component, I think, wasn't I? So why is that then? Well, on paper, it looks like a great alternative to lithium. The clever science bods refer to it as a trivalent element, which means each of its atoms has three electrons in its outer shell, all of which can be given up as the atom becomes an ion. By contrast, lithium only has one electron in its outer shell. So in the context of battery chemistry, aluminium packs triple the bang for your buck, right? Well, no. Because aluminium ions are small and have a strong positive charge on account of losing three negatively charged electrons, the electric field around them is very intense. It's what the chemistry folks called high charge density, and it actually makes it more difficult for ions to move between the electrodes because they tend to strongly interact with the surrounding materials, either in the electrodes themselves or in the electrolyte solution. So one of the main challenges for battery chemists has been to find electrode materials and electrolytic solutions that can overcome that problem. Existing attempts at aluminium ion batteries use expensive ionic liquid electrolytes that are much less stable than lithium ion battery electrolytes and are often quite corrosive, which makes it hard to scale up to safe, economically viable mass production. Aluminium ion chemistries typically operate at lower voltages than lithium ion cells too, and have much lower overall energy density as measured in watt hours per kilogram, despite their high theoretical capacity. Partly because cathode materials that have so far been shown to work with aluminium ions have had to be bulky and heavy, which offsets any energy density advantage. And chemists have been frustrated by very poor cycle life as a result of aluminium ions' annoying tendency to cause structural breakdown in the electrodes and form those pesky dendrites that we've talked about so many times on this channel. So when a new bunch of researchers publish a paper claiming an aluminium ion battery that retains over 99% of its original capacity after 10,000 charge-discharge cycles, the optimism with which we greet that paper should probably err very strongly towards the cautious end of the spectrum, don't you think? Well, here it is, folks, a new research paper claiming exactly those performance figures. It's from a group of boffins at the Institute of Advanced Structural Technology, which is part of the Beijing Institute of Technology in China. In fairness, Chinese battery chemists have proven to be quite good at coming up with smart solutions in recent years. So although we're only talking about laboratory test data here, it's probably worth at least having a look at how they've achieved their apparently impressive results. The first job was to find an alternative to the aluminium chloride liquid electrolytes typically used in existing setups. That's a nasty corrosive solution which is highly sensitive to moisture, leading to poor performance over time. And of course, it can be very hazardous to health if you're unlucky enough to be exposed to its toxic fumes. To overcome that challenge, the Beijing team added an inert aluminium fluoride salt to an electrolyte containing aluminium ions. The researchers explained that the aluminium fluoride salt has a 3D porous structure that allows ions to more easily move across the electrolyte. That not only increases conductivity, but it also makes the whole structure more durable. They also focused on the electrodes themselves and looked for ways to minimize those unhelpful ionic reactions that I mentioned earlier. The solution for that was to use fluoroethylene carbonate to create a very thin coating on the cathode and anode faces. That so-called solid electrode interface, or SEI, encouraged a much more uniform surface deposition and dissolution of aluminium, which prevented the formation of aluminium crystals that are a well-known cause of aluminium ion battery health degradation. It also went a long way towards eliminating the dangerous dendrites that in extreme circumstances can cause quite nasty conflagrations in lithium ion batteries. In the lab, the researchers say these cells withstood repeated jabs with a sharp object and performed quite happily at temperatures as high as 200 degrees Celsius, trundling along all the way up to 10,000 charge-discharge cycles with less than 1% loss of capacity. And as a nice bonus, the aluminium foils can be cleaned and reused almost indefinitely, and the aluminium fluoride can be easily washed out of the electrolyte and recycled into another battery with conversion efficiencies greater than 80%. Energy density still doesn't match up to lithium ion, unfortunately, but it wasn't terrible. The researchers tested cells at voltages between 0.1 and 2.4 volts and at various charge and discharge rates, and they got results that roughly equate to something like 150 watt-hours per kilogram, which is less than half the energy density of market-leading NMC lithium ion chemistry. So will we see aluminium ion batteries powering the electric cars and trucks of the future? Very unlikely. But there's a reasonable chance that aluminium ion chemistry could play a major role in the expansion of large utility-scale stationary battery energy storage, which by the way is growing at breakneck speed right now, due to overtake pumped hydro in 2025 as the world's largest energy storage technology. It looks like these batteries could be inherently safer than existing lithium-ion chemistry, and if battery chemists can use cheap abundant materials like aluminium and other alternatives like sodium in the bulky non-movable energy storage sector where energy density is far less of an issue, then that frees up all the higher performance lithium for use in smaller mobile applications like electric vehicles, doesn't it? So, you know, every little helps, eh? No doubt you've got your own views on this one, and you may even work in the industry. So, as always, the place to leave your thoughts and pearls of wisdom is in the comments section below. That's it for this week, though. Thanks, as always, to the amazing folks over at Patreon who keep the content on this channel completely independent and enable me to keep ads and sponsorship messages out of your way. If you enjoy these little videos and you feel you could support the work I do here each week at Just Have a Think, then jump over to patreon.com/justhaveathink to find out how you can join the team and have a look at all the exclusive perks you can get there, including additional Patreon-only videos and monthly content polls. Don't forget to visit the Everything Electric London website to check out what's on and get your discounted tickets using the Just Have a Think code. And if you're really feeling kind-hearted, you can hugely support the channel absolutely for free simply by hitting the subscribe button on YouTube and clicking on all notifications. Might seem like a trivial thing to do, but it really does help get us noticed by the YouTube algorithm, which means you get to see more videos like this one each week. It's just a couple of clicks away, either down there somewhere or on that icon there. Most important of all though, thanks very much for watching. Have a great week, and remember to just have a think. See you next week.